Good morning friends, welcome to the second session of root based vocabulary. In the first session we have learned number of words. In the second session we start with our first root, that is new. That root is new, right? By the name new itself, new, right? The meaning of the term new is new. Number of words are there: neophyte, we have neophyte, neonate. Then you have neocracy, neomania, neocracy, and then you have neomania, neomania, neomania. By the term neo means new. When I talk about neophyte is a beginner. Beginner, trio, we also use one more word for that is trio, beginner, who has started. Neonate is a new child. New child who has just born, he is taken as neonate. Neocracy, it means a government or rule by inexperienced people or new persons who are very inexperienced. So sometime that neocracy is used for Mr. Arvind Kejriwal in Delhi when he joined in last year. That is neocracy. Neomania is a festival of new moon. Is a festival of new moon, that is said to be neomania. Right, the next word I am going to take here is pyre. One, the next root is pyre. Pyre means fire. Fire. Okay, we use the word pyre, it means fire. A number of things are there. The pyre we use, then you have pyrogenic, then you have pyromaniac. Pyromaniac, right? When I say pyre is generally used for a word in Hindi, that is chita, or we may say it's a pile of burning material for performing the funeral rite. So we can say it's a pile of burning material for funeral rites. Burning material for funeral rites, that is said to be a pyre. In Hindi, we use a word for this, that is chita. Then you have pyrogenic. Pyrogenic means generating heat, because we know that a pyre deals with fire. Pyrogenic is a material that generates heat. So we can say generating heat. We use the word pyrogenic. Then you have pyromaniac, one who sets fire. One who sets fire means jo aag lagata, that is said to be pyromaniac, right? So here we have understood two roots here. First one is neo, neophyte, neonate, neocracy. Then you have neomania. Then you have pyre. That is pyre. It's a pile of burning material. Pyrogenic. And then you have pyromaniac. Right. The next thing I am going to take is, that is astro. By the term astro, we mean stars. Generally, astro is used at number of places. Astrology. Astronaut, astronomer, then we may also take it as astrometer, right? We may also have the word that is asterisk. What more word we can take? That is said to be asteroid. Okay, we know that astro means star. When I say astrology is a study of stars, that is used for telling the fate of the people depending on the stars, that is said to be astrology. We use astrologer. Astrologer are the persons who practice that. They are said to be astrologers. Astrologers. Then we have astronaut. We use astronaut. Astronaut contains of two things, astro and note. Note means sailing. You know about cosmonaut, nautical mile, right? So here I am talking about astronaut. Astronaut are the persons who go in the stars, right? Then you have astronomer. Astronomer means are the persons who studies the heavenly bodies. They are said to be astronomers. Then you have astrometer. एस्ट्रोमीटर मीन्स इंस्ट्रूमेंट दैट मेजर्ड हेवनली बॉडी दैट आर सेड टू बी एस्ट्रोमीटर. आस्टिक्स इज फॉर्म ऑफ ए स्टार. एस्ट्रॉइड, एस्ट्रॉइड इज ए पार्ट ऑफ द स्टार. इट्स लाइक ए स्टार दैट इज सेड टू बी एस्ट्रॉइड. एंड एस्ट्रोलॉजर्स आर द पर्सन्स हु प्रैक्टिस एस्ट्रोलॉजी, राइट. तो व्हाट आई कैन से दैट ऑल वर्ड्स इन एस्ट्रो डील्स विद द स्टार. एस्ट्रोलॉजी मीन्स स्टडी ऑफ द स्टार्स फॉर टेलिंग द फेट्स ऑफ द पीपल. एस्ट्रोनोट, एस्ट्रोनोट आर द सेलर्स ऑफ द यूनिवर्स. दे गो टू डिफरेंट हेवनली बॉडीज. दे आर सेड टू बी एस्ट्रोनोट्स हु गो इन द स्पेस. देन यू हैव एस्ट्रोमीटर. एस्ट्रोमीटर आर द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स दैट मेजर द हेवनली बॉडीज. Astric is a word used for like a star. That symbol is being made of that. That is said to be astric symbol. Then you have asteroid. Asteroid means like a star. Then you have astrologer, as well as you have also a term astronomer. Right? So these are the words that are being made with the root astro. Right? In my last lecture, I told you one word that is said to be pedometer. So I am going to start with that. I used a word. Pedometer, that will a instrument for measuring the walking. Here we have a word ped, P-E-D, that is used for a child. Ped, that is used for a child. So we have here that pedagogue. Then you have pediatrician. Right. Then you have pedophilia. Right. When I say pedagogue means a person who teaches the child. That is a teacher. Pedagogue is teacher. And when we say pedagogy, that is a generally word that is used by the teachers. Pedagogy. Pedagogy is the style of teaching. Or we can say pedagogy is a way by which you teach. Right. That is your style of teaching. That is said to be pedagogy. Then you have pediatrician, is a doctor for child, is a doctor for children. So that doctor is known as pediatrician, doctor for children. Okay. And then you have, that is pedophilia. Here we have one more root, that is phylen. P-H-I-L-I-E-N. The root is P-H-I-L-I-E-N. The meaning of this root is love. Right. If I say pedophilia means a person who has excess love for child, that is said to be pedophilia, right? So here my root is pet. It means child. So we have pedagogue, then you have pediatrician, then you have pedophilia. By this word pedagogue, we have some more words also. That is said to be demagogue. Demagogue means who leads the group, right? So here I can say dema, right? That is for the people. A person who teaches the people, who leads the group, that is said to be a leader. That is said to be demagogue. The word demagogue is used for the leader, right? With that, the following words we can make with the help of the root, that is said to be pet, right? Here we have taken one more root, that is said to be P-H-I-L-I-E-N, philen. It means love. So now I am going to, in the next part of my session, I am going to take this word philen, P-H-I-L-I-E-N, that means love. P-H-I-L-I-E-N, it means love. Okay, now when I start with this, so we have number of things here. Number of words are there. Bibliophile, philanthropist, T-H-R-O-P-I-S-T, we have philanthropist. Then you have philanderer. P-H-I-L-A-N-D-R-E-R. We have a word philanderer. E-R-E-R. Philanderer. Then we have that is philae. P-H-I-L-A. Philatelist. First. That is used for the stamp collector. Then you have that is said to be philogynist. P-H-I-L-O-G-Y-N-I-S-T. Philogynist. Right. Then you have one more word. Philologist. P-H-I-L-O-L-O-G-I-S-T, right? In the last, I told you pedophilia, right? So whatever the words I have used here, all words contain the root phylen, P-H-I-L-I-E-N. When I say bibliophile, it means a lover of books. The word biblio is used for the books. If I say bibliophile, it means a lover of books. Philanthropist. It is made of two words, philia and anthropos. Anthropos means mankind. So if I say philanthropist means lover of mankind. We can take care of that. Lover of mankind. Then I say philanderer, philanderer, andros. Earlier I told you andros means for male. If I say philanderer, philanderer means male flirt. Male flirt means a person who loves with male, that is said to be philanderer. Then I say philatelist. Philatelist is lover of stamp collection. Lover of stamp collection. A person who collects the stamp, so I can say that is lover of stamp collection. Then we have philogynist. Philo, love, gynist, gyne, woman. It means lover of woman. That is said to be lover of woman. That is said to be philogynist. Right? Then we have philologist. Philologist means a lover of languages. Right? So we can say that philologist is used for a student who is lover of different languages. We can say that is said to be a philologist. Okay? And then you have pedophilia. Pedophilia, earlier I told you, it's a lover of children. Excessive lover of children, that is said to be pedophilia. Okay? Now, in this, we have taken some more roots also. First one is biblio. The next root I'm taking from here is biblio. When I talk about the biblio deals with books. Okay? If you are a researcher, if you're studying a number of books, or if you have written an article, so at the end of that, you find bibliography. Bibliography. We use a word that is said to be bibliography. I have taken the word bibliomania and bibliopole. The next is bibliomania. Bibliomania. And next word I have taken is bibliopole. Okay. Now we know that any word that contains the word biblio, it means that deals with the books. If I say bibliography, bibliography is list of books at the end of an article. It is the list of the books. List of books at end of an article. At end of an article, if an article is written, so at the end where the list of the books have been given, what books have been referred for that article, that is said to be bibliography. Then you have bibliomania. A passion for collecting of books. A person who is mad towards books, we can say bibliomania means a person who has a passion for collecting books. So that is said to be bibliomania. And then you have bibliopole. Bibliopole means a person who deals in books, a person who buys or sells books. Who deals in buying and selling of books, that is said to be bibliopole. Right? So what I can say that in the next part we have taken two roots, philein, that is love. Next is biblio, it means books. Bibliophile, philanthropist, philanderer, philatelist, philogynist, philologist, pedophilia, bibliography, list of the books, bibliomania, passion for collecting of the books, bibliopole. So I can say a person who buys and sells a book, right? So here I also want to discuss one more very important root here, that is opposite to the word philia. Here I have taken the word philia, that means love. I have used the word philanthropist. When you talk about the philanthropist, you have also heard a word misanthropist, right? The next root that I am going to take here, that is opposite to this philin. It means misin. Misin, misin, that means hate. It means hate, right? The number of words we have on this misanthropist. Misanthropist, misogamist, then you have misogynist, gynist, misogynist, then you have misappropriate, that's a general word that we use in English, misappropriate, appropriate, misappropriate, then you have misopedia, then you have misandrist. Misopedia, and then you have misandrist, misandrist, right? You may also misomaniac, misothist, misogamy, misomaniac, misomaniac, misothist, and then you have misogamy. Zenny, misogyny, MISOXENY, right? Now we know that the root that I have taken, that is mission, MISIEN, it means hate. It means any word that have this as a prefix that somewhere deals with hating, right? For example, if I say misanthropist, anthropos I told you, philanthropist, a lover of mankind, misanthropist means an hater of mankind. One who hates mankind, that is said to be misanthropist, a person who hates mankind, misanthropist. Then you say misogamist, gamos, marriage, a person who hates the institution of marriage. So we can say that is said to be misogamist. Then misogynist, gynist means woman, a person who hates women, that is said to be misogynist. Misandrist, andros means male, one who hates male, that is said to be misandrist, right? Misopedia, pedia means child, one who hates child. One who hates child, that is said to be misopedia. Then you have misappropriate, that you know where appropriation is not done in a good way, in a fair way, that is said to be misappropriation. Misomaniac, then the next word is misomaniac, one who hates everything, misomaniac, sorry, the word is misomaniac. Misomaniac means one who hates everything. One who hates everything, that those persons are said to be misomaniac. Some persons you find in your day-to-day life that they are so much criticizing that they hate everything, right? That they are said to be misomaniac. Then you have misotheist. Misotheist means theism. I told you about God, theist, atheist, theology, pantheon, the words I have used in the earlier lecture. It is misotheist means a person who hates God. That is said to be misotheist, hates God. Then you have misogyny. Misogyny means a person who hates foreigners. Hates foreigners. F-O-R-E-I-G-N-E-R-S. For the word zany, we have one more word that is said to be xenophobia. Xenophobia. Xenophobia means fear from foreigners. So we can say xenophobia. Phobia means a fear. So here we can use this word xenophobia, means a fear from foreigners. Fear from foreigners, that is said to be xenophobia. Right? Now pay attention again on the words that I have taken is misin, that is hate, misanthropist, misogamist, misogynist, misappropriate, misopedia, misandrist, misomaniac, misotheist. Right? Here, misanthropist, mankind, hater of mankind, misogamist, gamos, marriage, hater of marriage, misogynist, gyne, woman, hater of woman, misopedia, pedia, child, it means hater of child, misandrist, andros, male, mis person who hates male, misomaniac, who hates everything, misotheist, theist means god, a person who hates god, right? Next you have misogyny, who hates foreigners, right? Here we have one more word that is said to be xenophobia. So xenophobia means what we can say that is a fear from foreigners, that is said to be xenophobia, fear from foreigners. I hope the idea is clear now, right? Means mission means hate. Now I am going to take this root gamist, gamos. Gamos means marriage. Number of words I have earlier used in my earlier lecture also. The next root is gamos, G-A-M-O-S, that means marriage, right? The words we have bigamy, monogamy, polygamy, misogamy, right? Then also we have octogamy, sexogamy, the next word we have sexogamy, gamete, G-A-M-E-T-E, the next word we have that is said to be gamete. Okay, when I talk about these words, gamos means marriage, so bigamy means institution of two marriages, that is said to be bigamous, monogamy, one marriage, so we can say bigamy means two marriages, monogamy means one marriages, polygamy means number of marriages, right? Then you have misogamy, hater of the marriage, octogamy, octogamy means being married to eight spouses. Octogamy means person who has eight spouses, right? A person who married for eight times, that is said to be ऑक्टोगैमी राइट, देन इज सेक्सोगैमी। सेक्सोगैमी मीन्स ए मैरिज दैट इज ओनली फॉर सेक्सुअल अट्रैक्शन। समटाइम्स सम पर्सन गो फॉर मैरिज ओनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर सेक्सुअल अट्रैक्शन, दे डोंट हैव एनी अंडरस्टैंडिंग, दैट इज सेड टू बी सेक्सोगैमी। सेक्सोगैमी मीन्स ए मैरिज ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ, ए मैरिज ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ सेक्सुअल अट्रैक्शन, राइट, दैट इज सेड टू बी सेक्सोगैमी। Then you have gamete. Gamete means it is said to be being that is said to be a specialized male or female cell. It is basically a male cell. When I talk about the gamete, it is specialized male cell. Specialized male cell that is said to be gamete, right? So here, what we have understood here is that simply deals with gametes. That means marriage, bigamy, monogamy, polygamy, misogamy. We know all the meaning of these roots now. Then we have octogamy. Octo means for eight. Octagon that we have heard. So we can say octogamy. It means a person who has eight spouses, but he married for eight times. Then we have sexogamy. Sexogamy means the marriage is only because of the sexual attraction. And then you have gamete, is a specialized male cell, right? That is said to be gamete. That term is generally used in the biology, gamete. Okay? Now after that, I'm going to take two very important points here, two important suffixes. They are basically suffixes. The first one is archy, archy. Right? When I talk archy, it means rule by. Earlier I have used this word archy at number of places. We are going to start with monarch or monarchy, right? Polyarchy. Then we have the word biarchy, matriarch, matriarch, patriarchy, right? Similarly, we have oligarchy, oligarchy. We know that any word that have the archy in the end, it simply deals with rule. If I say monarchy, monarchy means rule by one person, because the root here mono is one, so we may say that it is rule by one person. Then I say polyarchy, rule by number of persons, rule by many. Then we say biarchy, rule by two persons, matriarchy, where the mother is the head of the institution. We know that in India, some societies are there, they are basically patriarchal in nature, where the father is supreme, father is the head of the family, and some families are there which are matriarchal, means where the mother is the head of the family. So we have this term, matriarchy and patriarchy. Then we have oligarchy. Oligarchy means government in the hands of few persons. It means government in the hands of few persons, so they are said to be oligarchy. Government in the hands of a few persons, they are said to be oligarchy. ठीक है? तो if you have archy behind any of the word, it means rule by, and then you have crazy. Similarly, you have one word crazy, CRACY. It means government by. It means government by. Now I am going to discuss some words here that ends in crazy. The most common word that you have that is said to be democracy. Then you have autocracy. Democracy, autocracy, theocracy. You have plutocracy. Right? Then further you have aristocracy. Then you have aristocracy. If I take this, democracy means government by the people, of the people, and for the people. Government by the people, of the people, and for the people. Right? That we have in India, by the people, of the people, and for the people. That is said to be democracy. Okay? Then you have autocracy, government by one person. That is said to be, auto means one, self. We can say government by one person, ruled by one person. That is said to be autocracy. That is also said to be dictatorship. Autocracy means डिक्टेटरशिप, देन यू हैव थियोक्रेसी. थियो मीन्स आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू गोट, इट मीन्स गवर्नमेंट बाय गोट, गवर्नमेंट बाय गोट. देन यू हैव प्लूटोक्रेसी. प्लूटोक्रेसी मीन्स रूल बाय रिच पर्सन. प्लूटो, यू नो दैट इट्स ए गॉड ऑफ मनी. प्लूटो, तो वी मे से दैट इट्स अ रूल बाय रिच पर्सन. वी कैन से दैट इज सेड टू बी प्लूटोक्रेटी, इट्स सेड टू बी प्लूटोक्रेसी. देन यू हैव अरिस्टोक्रेसी. एरिस्टोक्रेसी मीन्स रूल बाय पीपल ऑफ हाई नोबल क्लास, रूल बाय पीपल ऑफ हाई नोबल क्लास. हाई नोबल क्लास दे आर सेड टू बी एरिस्टोक्रेसी, राइट? तो एनी वर्ड दैट एंड्स इन एंड एंड्स इन क्रेसी, दैट सिंपली मीन्स दैट इज सेड टू बी गवर्नमेंट बाय द पीपल और रूल बाय द पीपल. देन यू हैव ब्यूरोक्रेसी, इट मीन्स गवर्नमेंट बाय ऑफिशियल्स. ऑफिशियल्स मीन्स अ ब्यूरोक्रेट्स. देन यू हैव डुलोक्रेसी. वन मोर वर्ड आई हैव टेकन है डुलोक्रेसी. डुलोक्रेसी मीन्स रूल बाय स्लेव्स. इट इज रूल बाय स्लेव्स, दैट इज सेड टू बी डुलोक्रेसी, राइट? तो आई होप द आइडिया इज क्लियर नाउ. वट वुड आई हैव टेकन अर्लियर, आई हैव टेकन आर्की, इट मीन्स रूल बाय. क्रेसी, इट मीन्स गवर्नमेंट बाय एंड रूल बाय. इफ आई से डेमोक्रेसी, डेमो वर्ड आई हैव यूज अर्लियर नंबर ऑफ टाइम. डेमागोग आई टोल्ड यू, डेमोग्राफी आई टोल्ड यू. इट मीन्स डेमोक्रेसी मीन्स गवर्नमेंट बाय द पीपल, ऑफ द पीपल एंड फॉर द पीपल. देन यू हैव ऑटोक्रेसी, गवर्नमेंट बाय वन पर्सन, दैट मे ऑल्सो बी टेकन एज डिक्टेटरशिप. देन यू हैव थियोक्रेसी, इट मीन्स गवर्नमेंट बाय वोट. देन यू हैव प्लूटोक्रेसी, इट्स ए रूल बाय रिच पर्सन. अरिस्टोक्रेसी, गवर्नमेंट बाय हाई नोबल पर्सन. Then you have bureaucracy, it's a government by officials, and then you have a dulocracy, it's a rule by slaves.